Good morning, hope you're having an amazing day. It's Mark Wiens. We're in Kerala in the state of India, and today is gonna be a mix of local food. But mainly, we're first coming to the market, and Eben has invited us over to his family home, where a grandmother is gonna prepare for us a fish curry, a fresh fish curry. We're gonna see the process of her making it. And first we're gonna go to the market and buy fish, and I'll be sharing all of the food with you in this video. I'm just waking up out of the van.
Yeah.
Where are we at?
We are at Chenganasheri. We are going to visit a fish market here. We'll buy some fish, we'll cook some fish, we'll eat.
So we're gonna get the day started here. We're about to go walking in the market. Walking towards the market already. The action is starting to pick up the produce, the colors. Such a relaxing morning. And this is a small chapel here, which is an icon of this city, of this market area. I'm loving how calm and peaceful it is. Coconut oil.
Dry fish?
Dry fish, yes. Coconut oil and dry fish is what I can smell. Or maybe the coconuts.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to the market. That's where the dry fish is.
Oh, yes.
This is dry fish.
Hey, just quickly step inside this section of the market full of dry fish. All on the salt, just dry. There's shrimp as well. That aroma is wonderful. And what's interesting about this fish market, this market, is that there's a mix of both seawater, because we're not that far from the sea, and also fresh water, because we're actually on the backwaters, where water is brackish, where there's a mix of lakes and rivers and canals. Those are the pearl spot fish, which are famous in the backwaters as well. Oh, it's even on the lens. I just got splattered.
Yes, so many.
We chose the fish to buy. It's about six and a half kilo. What was the name of the fish again?
Mora.
And some type of a kingfish. Not totally sure the English name.
Yeah.
Local name is Mora. Jatin here is gonna chop it up for us.
No.
Shark.
Hiata.
Good. He's so fast. Such an expert at chopping fish and knowing the anatomy of the fish and the way to cut it. This one, peel back, he just like peels back the skin, pulls off the skin. I think the skin looks like so leather, I think it's inedible. In just a matter of like less than 5 minutes, he cubed that entire fish. It's just in like perfect cubes. And what's amazing is his precision chopping and the way every piece is almost the same size. We got the fish. That was a great morning market. Nice and relaxed. People are so friendly. We're now on our way to the house to get started cooking. On our way back to the force, we're stopping for a quick cup of chai, just because his stall looks so cool. It's like a whole cabinet. Everything contained within this like boxed in, caged in cabinet. Perfect spot under the awning, next to the tree, next to the chapel. It's just, this place is so quiet and peaceful. Like there's no honking. No honking is in the air. It's just
even though it is very close to the market.
Yes. But even the market is quite laid back. Yeah. Very laid back. The frothy, milky morning wake up. Okay, back to the force. We arrived to the house. This neighborhood, it's like countryside neighborhood. It's so beautiful, so lush. And two main dishes that we're gonna make. We met with the entire family, Eben's family. They're so kind, so hospitable. And they're gonna make the fish curry. And then also he's gonna make for us a special cassava biryani, which is something I've never had before. I've had biryani countless times, all with rice. But this one is gonna be made with cassava, and he's gonna cook this outside over open fire.
Open it.
Okay, you open it.
Give me some water. I'm a mimi nam and then.
Immediately slicing it up, and that is a pomelo.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Pink pomelo right off the tree seconds ago.
Okay. Oh, you got such a nice chunk.
It's so juicy and sweet.
Spices, chili, coriander, Kashmiri chili, coconut oil, curry leaves.
For the biryani, right?
For the biryani.
Oh, curry leaves. I just want to bury my face in curry leaves. Oh, they're so good. And they're so flavorful. And they're used in almost everything. Still gathering all the ingredients and laying out the spices. Half the ingredients are like the dry spices available from the cabinet in the kitchen. The other half are just foraged or grown right here, like just all around the property. There's just ingredients, lush ingredients everywhere you look. So many edible things, like chilies, and the pepper vines are just going all the way up the trees. So many amazing spices and flavors. Love the colorful assortment of spices and ingredients right now. They're just chopping up the onions and the chilies to begin. They're smashing. And as he continues to prepare the spices, Arun is over here lighting up the fire.
Fresh water.
Fresh water.
For drinking.
Yeah, for drinking. For drinking, for cooking.
നമ്മളെ കിണറ്റിലെ വെള്ളമാണ് നല്ല ഫ്രഷ് വെള്ളമാണ്
കപ്പ കപ്പ വേവിക്കാനായിട്ട്
അതെ.
And every house here has their own spring of fresh water. Fire is ready, the spices are ready. Now to boil some water.
അപ്പോൾ നമസ്കാരം, ഞാൻ ഉണ്ണി ജോർജ്. വെൽക്കം ടു OMKV കുക്കിംഗ്. ഇതുണ്ട്, ഇത് ആരാന്ന് അറിയാലല്ലോ, പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് പറയണ്ട.
He was saying that he needs somebody to translate between. Thank you.
So he's also making a video for his channel about this experience, and I'll have it linked below. But he's cooking, just got started now with the cassava. Put the cassava into water, and that's going to be over fire. Cassava is continuing to boil. They're feeding the flames with coconut shells, and Uncle just came with a, it's the midrib, the stem of the leaf, which they're gonna stir and also mash the cassava with.
Okay, our cassava is ready now.
Okay, cassava is ready, and it's that color is beautiful from the yellow from the turmeric. That's gonna be combined with the spices, with the meat. I think it's beef ribs, right?
Yeah,
beef ribs, which have already been cooked to make this cassava biryani.
അപ്പൊ ഇനി നമ്മള് താളിക്കാൻ പോണേ വെളിച്ചെണ്ണ കുറച്ച് മുഴുവൻ നമ്മുടെ സ്പൈസസ്.
Okay, next part of the recipe is cooking the spices. Simmered some coconut oil and now a spice blend goes in. There's cardamom, there's cloves, there's cinnamon. Immediately, the fragrance.
Salad as well as garlic.
Crumb. Mashed already, right?
Mashed. Yes.
Okay.
This is Kashmiri chili.
Kashmiri chili.
This is hot chili.
Hot chili.
Yeah. Mm. Coriander powder and meat masala.
Okay.
Sure. Once the onions are caramelized with the curry leaves, the dry mixture, the dry spice mixture goes in. Kashmiri chili for color, strong chili for heat and spice, coriander and type of masala.
This is buffalo beef.
Buffalo beef.
Buffalo beef ribs.
Pre-cooked already.
Yeah.
With some spices.
Yes.
Crushed black pepper goes in. Getting the chance to stir it up. So the beef ribs are in here, and then we just added the crushed black pepper. So not dry, okay.
Okay.
And that spice will then enter the ribs fully, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, now cassava goes in.
One second. Okay, there's one spider.
There's a spider in there.
We are filling under them.
Okay,
do.
We shake it up.
Yeah. Yes.
You feel like the gumminess of that cassava, yeah.
A layer of salt.
Done, and then the next ingredient, this is coconut with turmeric.
ഇവിടെ കുറച്ച് തേങ്ങ ചേർക്കും. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ നന്നായിട്ട് കുഴയ്ക്കും കപ്പ.
തേങ്ങ മഞ്ഞപ്പൊടി
ഇട്ട് അടിച്ച്. Wait, so stir it all up too?
Yeah.
Okay, so we made the layers.
Mash it properly.
Mash it like...
Yeah.
Like that?
Like that.
Oh. Oh, you can just feel how the gumminess and the stickiness of that cassava. It just mashes at the same time as it stirs.
And you get the aroma of the mix.
Oh, the spices,
cassava.
Yeah.
Maybe if you need a wider view.
Oh, so you don't want to stir it too fast. You don't want it to... Different versions are different, right? But then some... You don't want it to be fully mashed. You want it like chunks as well.
Maybe that isn't it.
Okay.
Oh, it smells so good. The meat, now that the meat is mixed with it. Oh, that aroma.
ഉപ്പ് ഇച്ചിരി വേണം. ഉപ്പ് വേണം. ഉപ്പ് വേണം. ഇത് കഴിഞ്ഞ ഒരു ചെറിയൊരു പണി ഉണ്ട് ഇതിന്.
ചെറുള്ളി മറ്റൊന്നും കൂടെ.
ഇവിടെ വെക്കാൻ സൗകര്യം ഉണ്ടോ? ഇവിടെ പൊട്ടില്ല. അത് ആ സ്റ്റൗ നിന്ന്
പൊട്ടിച്ചിട്ട് One more step to finish off the cassava biryani. There, we're coming in the house because it's a lot easier to sizzle the final ingredients, the shallots, curry leaves, and some other, the mustard seeds, which are gonna sizzle in coconut oil and then pour over the cassava biryani. That smells unbelievable. The caramelized shallots, the chili, the curry leaves.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh.
Turn it over?
Yeah.
Wow,
that's incredible. So that completes the cassava biryani preparation. From here, we're going into the house and the aunties are gonna make for us the fish curry. And the fish curry is gonna be to eat along with the cassava.
Grandma's gonna cook.
Yes. We met Grandma. She's been just smiling and just, she's beautiful. She's gonna guide us as we cook the curry.
Yes, this is Kottayam style fish curry.
Kottayam style.
Kottayam. Kottayam is this place name.
This place, okay.
Kottayam style fish curry with pat tamarind. This is the pat tamarind.
Yes. For that sourness, right?
Yeah.
So all the spices are laid out. And I love, there's just like mountains of spices that are gonna go in. She's beginning with coconut oil in a clay pan. Okay, so once that oil reached smoke point, then she added in the ginger and garlic and then sprinkled in some curry leaves. It's such an honor to be standing here with Grandma, decades of experience in culinary wisdom, and that just smells unbelievably good. The curry leaves sizzling, the garlic, the ginger. Coriander? Okay, yes. Coriander, Kashmiri chili, strong chili. The entire plate of spices goes in. Just mounds of spices for that amount of fish. Oh, it's so beautiful. It's so aromatic. And then she poured in some water to create like the spice paste. Yes. Pot tamarind goes in. That's gonna give it the flavor, the sour flavor. And then she puts in the cubes of fish. That's the fish that we bought at the market earlier this morning, and then she's topping that with some water. That's gonna simmer away. I think that's the main bulk of the spices, the main bulk of the flavor now. And now it just needs to like simmer to harmony, to blend everything together in a sweet harmony of Kerala spices.
Yeah, she's so awesome.
So it's time to eat.
We have a surprise appetizer course.
Yeah.
We are sitting down, the food is served. It is an honor to have a place at this table with Grandma as well. It smells so good. And you can never get enough of her smile. Ever. Okay. And Evan is gonna serve us, and this is like a surprise dish that we didn't even know about. The mutton stew and the appam. This is another one.
Vegetable.
Ah, okay. With coconut.
With coconut.
Awesome.
Vegetable stew.
Thank you.
All right.
Yes, please.
Thank you.
Mutton, kaiginilla. Karena vegetable stew ana.
All right.
Yes, please.
Thank you. I have to begin with that mutton stew, and you can see the peppercorns. The tenderness of it and the gravy. Oh, the tenderness of it. Wow. The pepper in there and the coconut oil and the mustard seed. Oh, and the tenderness of that mutton. Oh, it's so good. So the difference between the curry and stew is that it has more of the sweeter spices, I think. I can taste a lot of cinnamon. Yeah, a lot of cinnamon in there. And now this one is the vegetarian, the vegetable
stew
also. Mm.
Well, that one is amazing too. Like the vegetables just disintegrate on your tongue, then like wrapped up in that heavy coconut. The ginger in the stew too. The bones are just clean.
But don't immediately throw away the bone. You want to lick it first. Next, I'll try it with the plantain.
spicy stew with the sweet plantain. Thank you. Okay, round one is complete. And the next round, the next course is what we cooked, what we made, both the cassava biryani to eat with that fish curry. It's just that texture, and you can see the fibers of the cassava. You can see how it's mashed but chunky at the same time. And then that fish curry. That fish curry looks like a fish curry of wonders. We bought the fish this morning. They prepared it. This goes together. Look at that gravy. Oh, the whole strand of curry leaves. Mix the fish or just try? I'll just try the first, just the biryani. Oh, the stickiness of that. And that gumminess from the cassava. Look at the texture. And you want that texture to be kind of like mashed but also chunky at the same time.
Too spicy.
Oh, the pepper in there. Immediately the mix of the green pepper and the black pepper, the dry pepper. And then you have this tender pieces of buffalo ribs in there that just like melt into the mash.
Break off some of that fish curry.
And the fish curry along with that, the sourness of that pot tamarind and those like heaping mounds of spices. It's such a curry leaf like driven by curry leaves. Take one more spoon of this insane curry sauce. The drinkable curry sauce. The mashedness of it and the like the blend of peppers mixed with the cinnamons and the cloves. Additionally, it's spicy on so many different layers, so many different levels. The pepper, the variety of chilies, the ginger. Those are like the three elements that make up the heat of it. And so it's not only like just spicy hot, but it's like spicious and just the layers of heat spice as well. All working together. The layers, right? Oh yeah, there's a bone chunk right there. And every now and then you have a bone of the rib. I'm just gonna strip this. Like you can eat curry leaves by the fishbowl too. Okay, and then finally to drink. Oh, that's so good. It's like it tastes like cinnamon. But not quite as strong and with a fruity flavor to it. Kind of like a mix of a bale fruit and cinnamon. And it's just like not sweet at all. They say it's a boiled bark, but very healthy, property tasting. And that just pairs so well. That's so good. What a spectacular meal. How was the meal?
The very, food? Good, very good.
Very good.
Very good.
Very good.
Excellent.
Awesome. Thank you to everybody who prepared this just outrageously delicious meal. And again, it comes to that sad moment. In the north of Kerala, you fold down when you're finished with your meal. In the south of Kerala, and I think central Kerala, you fold up. So that's it. I am wrapping it up. Complete. Yes. We said goodbye to the family. It was such an honor to have this meal opportunity. The food was incredibly delicious, but the people are what really made it special. And the cassava biryani is something I've never had before. I love the spices. I will have their link in the description box below, OMKV Fishing Channel. They do all sorts of cool videos about cooking and fishing in Kerala. So be sure to check out Eben's channel as well. And again, I want to say a big thank you for watching, and I will see you on the next video.